we are going to learn about the topic scan conversion of point, line, circle and ellipse. First, see the scan conversion of point. If we want to scan conversion of point, then we have to eliminate the pixel that contains the point. We have to eliminate the pixel on the screen, and the point will have the coordinate x, y. But both the coordinates should have the integer values, because our computer screen will contain only the integer points and not the floating point values. Does P1 having the floating and does P1 having the floating values 2.3, 1.8? P2 is having the floating point values as 2.7, 1.3. Both these values of coordinates of point P1 and P2 are converted into the integer values by performing the round off operation. So here we will get the same value for both the points, that is 2, 1, and we can represent it on the screen like this. Then next, see the scan conversion of line. Now in scan conversion of line, always the line is represented with two endpoints and the line equation. So here we have the two endpoints x1, y1 and x2, y2. Now we have to find out all the points which lie on this line with the help of equation, that is y is equals to mx plus b. Whereas m is the slope of the line and b is the y-intercept. So m is nothing but the difference in y direction, that is delta y, upon difference in x direction, that is delta x. Thus, by scan converting these calculated x and y values, we can represent the line as a sequence of pixels. Now, the scan conversion of circle. In the process of scan conversion of circle, the circle is divided into 8 equal parts. Here we have seen in this 8-way symmetry of a circle is divided into 8 equal parts, and each part is called as an octant, and each octant is of 45 degree. If we find out any one point which lie on the circle, we can calculate all the remaining 7 points. Suppose this is the point P1 having the coordinate x and y, then we can say P2 is having the coordinate y, x, P3 having the coordinate minus y, x, P4 having the coordinate minus x, y, and so on till point P8. We can represent these points on the circle on the computer screen with the help of putPixel function. This is having the syntax putPixel in bracket x, y, the color which we want to assign. The scan conversion of circle can be mathematically defined with the help of two methods, polynomial method and polar coordinate method. First, see the polynomial method. In the first method, we need two things, coordinate of the center and the radius of circle. For any point on the circle, x, y, this x, y is any point on the circle, and the coordinates of the center are xc, yc. Then we have the equation x, xc bracket square plus y, yc bracket square minus r square equals to 0. Now this circle is situated at the center. So the origin is situated at the origin. So origin is the center of the circle, which is having the coordinates 0, 0. It is having the coordinate 0. So here xc and yc will be 0. So finally we will get the equation x square plus y square equals to r square. So in this way, we can find out the circle using the polynomial method. Next is the scan conversion of circle using the polar coordinate. Now with the help of polar coordinate, we can also draw the circle on the screen. So here, we will consider any point on the circle having the coordinate x and y. So x is nothing but r cos theta and y is nothing but r sine theta. Here theta is the current angle, r is the radius, and x and y are the coordinates. So r cos theta is in x direction and r sine theta is in y direction. These are the points, coordinates of the point. By using this method, we use this theta from 0 to pi by 4 and each value of x and y will be calculated. So we just need to use the various values of this theta varying from 0 to pi by 4 and we can get the different points on the circle and we can draw the circle using polar coordinates. Next is scan conversion of ellipse. Ellipse is an elongated circle. Therefore, elliptical curve can be generated by modifying circle drawing procedures. To take into account the different dimensions of an ellipse along the major and minor axis. Now, as we know, circle is an 8-way symmetry. It is having 8 octants. Unlike that, ellipse is a 4-way symmetry. It is having only 4 octants. So, if we calculate any one point, we can find out the value of other 3 points. In that way, we can draw the ellipse. Now, we have different properties of ellipse. What are the different properties of ellipse? We can create the ellipse by performing stretching on a circle in x and y direction. If we stretch the any coordinates of the x and y, then we can get the ellipse. Every ellipse has 2 focal points called foci. In standard form, we can write the ellipse equation as x minus h bracket square upon a square plus y minus k bracket square upon b square equals to 1. Whereas h and k are the center coordinates of the circle. And we have here 2 major axes which are required while drawing an ellipse, that is the major axis and minor axis. So a and b are these axes. So this is the major axis and this is the minor axis which are required to draw the ellipse, which divides the ellipse into 4 different parts. Now, there are 2 standard methods for mathematically defining an ellipse. First is polynomial method and second is trigonometric method. Now, let's see the polynomial method. It is given by the equation x minus h square by a square plus y minus k bracket square by b square equals to 1. Now, as we have seen this figure, this ellipse is having the center other than the origin. So, if it is at the origin, the coordinates will be 0, 0. Now, it is other than origin. So, we can find out the value of coordinates h and k as h we have to measure from x-axis and k we have to measure from y-axis. In that way, we will find out the value of h and k. Then, a will be major axis and b is minor axis. If we put the values in this formula, we will get the ellipse shape. Next is the trigonometric method. Trigonometric method is given by the equation x is equals to a cos theta plus h, y is equals to b sin theta plus k. Now in this, if the ellipse is situated other than the origin, then we have to find out the h and k with the help of x and y coordinate respectively, then the value of major axis A and minor axis B. So this center will have the coordinate A cos theta plus h and B sin theta plus k. So, and theta is the current angle which we have to consider. So by putting all these values in these coordinates, so we will get the different points on the ellipse. Thus, we can draw the ellipse using a trigonometric method. So this is all about the scan conversion of ellipse. Thank you.